بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم آئی ایم فران علی فرام گروپ جی ایم ایم 10 سو ٹوڈے وی ول ڈسکس اباؤٹ ڈرگز افیکٹنگ آن دا اینڈوکرائن سسٹم Endocrine system is a messenger system comprising feedback loops of the hormones released by the internal glands of the organism directly into the circulatory system. Regulating distant target organs in vertebrates, the hypothalamus is the neural control center for all endocrine system. In humans, the major endocrine glands are the thyroid gland and the adrenal glands. The study of the endocrine system and its disorders is known as the endocrinology. Endocrinology is a branch of the internal medicine. So drugs names: meglitinides, nitaglinides. Nitaglinides is an oral anti-diabetic agent that, when used in combination with metformin or resigliatazone to treat type 2 diabetes, has been shown to be effective in reducing HbA1c glycated hemoglobin relative to metformin or resigliatazone. Internal doses tablet 60 mg and 120 mg, parenteral doses and half life 1.4 hours. Next is thiazolinidazone, resigliatazone and pioglitazone. Internal doses tablets 2 mg milligram per and 4 mg. Tablets pioglitazone 15 mg, 30 mg and 45 mg and half life is 3 to 4 hours of resigliatazone and 3 to 7 hours of pioglitazone. Pioglitazone exert their anti-diabetic effects through a mechanism that involves activation of the gamma in form of the peroxisome proliferates. Activated receptors PPAR gamma are nuclear receptors or TZDs. Reduces insulin resistance in adipose tissues, muscles and in the liver. And that's it. Dipeptidyl peptidase 4 inhibitors. Allogliptin tablet 6.25 mg and 12.5 mg, 25 mg, and half life is 12.5 to 21 hours. And next is linagliptin tablet 5 mg and half life is 180 hours. The mechanism of dipeptidyl peptidase inhibitors is to increase incretin levels, glucagon like peptidyl A1 glucagon and glucose dependent insulinotropic peptide GIP, which inhibits glucagon release, which in turn increases insulin secretion, decreases gastric emptying and decreases blood glucose levels. Diabetic insipidus. Diabetes insipidus is characterized by extreme thirst and passing of large amounts of urine. It is caused by the lack of the sufficient vasopressin, a hormone produced by the brain that instructs the kidneys to retain water. Treatment options include vasopressin replacement. The symptoms of the diabetes insipidus includes extreme thirst that cannot be quenched, polydipsia, and excess amounts of urine, polyuria, colorless urine instead of pale yellow, walking frequently through the night to urinate, dry skin, constipation, weak muscles, and bedwetting. Vasopressin, brand name vasopressin, used to manage antidiuretic hormone deficiency. It has off-label uses. It is used in the treatment of the gastrointestinal bleeding, ventricular tachycardia, and ventricular defibrillation. Vasopressin is used to treat diabetes insipidus. Insipidus comes from the Latin language insipidus. Insipidus tasteless and related to the low levels of the antidiuretic hormones. And DDABP nasal spray, desmopressin acetate, is a synthetic analog of the natural pituitary hormone D8 arginine. Vasopressin, antidiuretic hormone and antidiuretic hormone affecting renal water conservation, diabetes insipidus, and next is replacement therapy. Internal doses of desmopressin acetate, synthetic analog, is intranasal spray stimulated. Parenteral dose 20 units per ml intravenous solutions and half life is 10 to 20 minutes. So this was all about the endocrinology and drugs that affects on the endocrine system. So thanks for watching.